knows a lot about the science stuff. Professor Dave explains.
It's now time to wrap up our study of the clade Lophophorata and of the much larger clade Spiralia by examining the phylum Phoronida, or the horseshoe worms. Phoronida contains only about 20 confirmed species. They, like all members of Lophophorata, filter feed using a lophophore, or a crown of tentacles. Most live on the substrate below shallow coastal waters, especially in temperate seas, though some have been discovered in the Arctic Ocean. They can range in size from just a few millimeters to 50 centimeters or more in length. However, most adults are about 2 centimeters long and about 1.5 millimeters wide. Let's now go over their anatomy and physiology and reproduction, followed by a phylogenetic overview. Each individual secretes a tough chitinous tube in which it lives. Their body wall consists of a cuticle, epidermis, and muscular system. Their bottom end is flattened into an ampulla, which anchors the animal in the tube and enables it to retract its body very quickly when threatened. However, this flattening makes it impossible for an individual horseshoe worm to ever leave its tube, though they can move freely within it. When feeding, they extend the lophophore out at the top of the body so that cilia on the sides of the tentacles draw food, such as plankton and detritus particles, to the mouth, which is inside and slightly to one side of the base of the lophophore. Their lophophore has two parallel ridges, which are curved into a horseshoe-like shape, hence their common name, though in smaller species, the crown merely resembles a simple circle. The gut runs from the mouth to one side of the stomach in the bottom of the ampulla. The intestine runs from the stomach up the other side of the body and ends at the anus, outside and a little below the crown of tentacles. Their anus is located on their dorsal end, the same side as the mouth, but outside of their lophophore and is flanked on each side by a nephridiopore, which is part of their excretory system. Their lophophore doubles as part of their excretory system. Since the sediment in which most horseshoe worms reside is anoxic, meaning it does not contain oxygen, they, unlike the bryozoans, cannot rely on simple diffusion for gas exchange. Instead, their lophophores double as their respiratory system. In addition to a digestive and excretory system, the Phoronidans also have a circulatory system, though they lack a heart. Instead, they have a single blood vessel that runs up the middle of the body to a circular vessel at the base of the lophophore, and from there, a single vessel runs up each tentacle. In addition, they have a pair of blood vessels near the body wall that lead downward from the lophophore ring. Remember that, in addition to feeding, the lophophore also functions in gas exchange, like a set of gills. So oxygenated blood is brought away from the lophophore. Instead of a heart, muscles in major blood vessels contract in waves to move blood. Their blood, which contains hemoglobin within nucleated cells, carries as much oxygen per cubic centimeter as that of most vertebrates. Their nervous system runs between the mouth and the anus, with a nerve ring at the base of the lophophore, along with a large motor fiber within the epidermis and an epidermal nerve plexus. The majority of Phoronids are monoecious, though some are dioecious. At least one species, Phoronis ovalis, is able to reproduce asexually through budding or by splitting into top and bottom sections, which then grow into full bodies and form colonies. However, most horseshoe worms produce gametes in swollen glands around the stomach. During the breeding season, sperm exit and are captured by other members of the same species, where they are used to fertilize eggs. Most Phoronids then brood their eggs within their bodies until they hatch into free-swimming actinotroch larvae, which feed on plankton. These unique larvae have a lobed top, or hood, which contains a nervous ganglion that connects to a patch of cilia, feeding tentacles, and a mouth. The larvae will swim or drift for a period of about 20 days, after which they undergo a radical change, or a catastrophic metamorphosis, in which they develop into adults. Now, before we finish up, it will be a good idea to quickly review the four phyla within Lophophorata, and this chart will be quite useful. As you can see, all four phyla have a coelom, except for Entoprocta. Protection and support vary by phylum, from the erect tubes of Phoronida to the valves of Brachiopoda to the mineralized bryozoans. Entoproctans lack any support structures. The tentacles of all the phyla are hollow, except for Entoprocta. The anus is located outside of the tentacle rings of Bryozoa and Phoronida. within the ring in Entoprocta, and within the mantle or lacking in Brachiopoda. Nearly all members of Bryozoa and Entoprocta are colonial. Only one species of Phoronida is colonial, and none of the brachiopods are colonial. In order to feed, bryozoans bring a current of water from the top of their crown down to their mouths, as does Phoronida. Brachiopoda brings water in through the sides of their shells, and Entoprocta draws water from below their rings up through their tentacles. And with that, we conclude our study not only of the Lophophoratans, but also Spiralia. This was quite the journey, but we are just getting started. Let's move forward and get an introduction to Spiralia's sister clade, Ecdysozoa.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.